In this video of the CANoe tutorial series, we'll have a closer look at automated testing. We create a test unit with two test cases to verify the CAN communication between the hospital bed and the remote control. Hello, I'm Christian from Vector Support. We have seen the capabilities of CANoe for explorative testing in the previous videos. We have manipulated signals in code and via panels. But for automated testing, it is much more convenient to simply click on a single button. This click then triggers a sequence of events that consists of a stimulation of the system under test and the analysis of the reaction of the same. These test sequences, so-called test units, can be created in the tool vTESTstudio, where we can also link requirements to test cases, allowing convenient traceability of requirements. vTESTstudio can also be connected to various ALM tools to automatically download requirements and upload test results, streamlining the process even further. Let us now create a new vTESTstudio project with a single test unit that includes two simple test cases. As a first step, we open vTESTstudio. We can now click on File and choose New Project. vTESTstudio prompts us to enter a file name and location for the newly created project. We will simply navigate to the folder where we have also saved our CANoe configuration, the tutorial, and create a new folder, vTESTstudio, in which we save the project. Then, we import the system environment from the currently open CANoe configuration via clicking on Environment, System Environment, Import CANoe System Environment and Symbols. This allows us to use the symbols used in our configuration in our vTESTstudio project. Within this project, we can now add a test unit. We do so by right-clicking on the project name in the project view on the left side. We simply name the test unit Hospital Bed. Finally, we add a so-called test table within the test unit. We also simply call it Hospital Bed. Within this test table, all test cases are collected. These test cases themselves consist of multiple steps like stimulation of signals and verifying the reaction of the system under test. Now that we have a vTESTstudio project with a single test unit and a test table, we can actually implement tests. The test cases that we want to add are meant to validate that the CAN node of the bed replies with a new head position when prompted and, depending on which button was pressed on the remote, the head position should increase or decrease. Because we want to verify changes in the bed position, we need to remember the initial bed position at the start of the test case. To do so, we create a test variable by clicking on Environment, Test System Variables, and New System Variable. This new variable is only available in the vTESTstudio project and will not clutter the trace window in CANoe. We give the new variable the name Head Position at Test Start and make it an unsigned integer. We can apply these changes and close the configuration window. Back in the test table, we first create a test fixture where we collect all our test cases. We do so by clicking on a line that says Command and then the appearing arrow and choose Test Fixture. Within this test fixture, we can add a new test case and a preparation step within the same. As I have mentioned, the preparation step is to store the head position at the start of the test in the newly created test variable. We can do so by simply assigning the value with the command set. We choose the test variable and the corresponding CAN signal. To increase the readability of this test step in the test table and in the automatically created test report, we add the caption store current head position in test variable. As the first actual step in the test case, we want to mimic the pushing of the up button of the remote. We do so by setting the value of head adjustment to 1. The next test step is to wait for 2 seconds. Because the value for head adjustment is still 1 during the wait time, the head is expected to move for 2 seconds. To then stop the movement, we set the value head adjustment back to 0. Because there is an upper limit for the head position cannot have changed if the initial position was at the maximum. We can simply add an if block where we can check whether the head position at test start was at the upper limit of 255. If so, the head position must still be at 255. Otherwise, we expect the position to be higher than at test start. Of course, real test cases are much more complicated than that. For example, you could also check the exact position where the head is expected to be, rather than just relative movement. Luckily, you are not limited to the few functionalities in vTESTstudio that we have used so far. In addition to setting and checking values directly in the test table, vTESTstudio allows you to implement sophisticated test cases in Python, C#, and Capel, similar to how application models can be created. For this tutorial, though, we want to focus on a simple test case. Let us now add the second test case, with the only difference being a movement down rather than up. We can simply copy the test case and only need to change the value set to -1 for the head adjustment signal, and set the values in the if cases. Now that we have designed both test cases in vTESTstudio, we need to get this information into CANoe, where the test cases are actually run. We simply build a test unit in vTESTstudio, which creates a .vtuexe file. This file will later be used in CANoe. So let us switch to CANoe, where we go to the Test tab and click on the Test Setup ribbon and Test Configuration. In this window, we will add a test configuration and give it a name. Here, we choose the name Automated Tests. Next, we need to add the test unit, which is the vtuexe file that we have built in vTESTstudio. As soon as the test unit has been imported, we can see the individual test cases. When we now start the measurement in CANoe, we can start the test with the play symbol on the top left of the test configuration window. While the tests are running, we can also see how the signal values change in the panels and in the graphics and trace windows that we have created previously. When the tests are finished, we can see the verdict for each test case. As expected, both tests pass. To get more details, we can open the automatically created test report and see each test step as a row. This report can be attached to the relevant documentation to speed up the verification and validation process of new devices. We have now seen how easy it is to design test cases in vTESTstudio and how to run them as automated tests in CANoe. We have seen that we have a means of analyzing the reaction of the system under tests in panels, while the tests are running, or afterwards in an automatically created test report. If you want to follow along this tutorial series, subscribe to our Vector Tech Tutorial channel for more videos and check out the playlist from the description. By the way, we of course also provide dedicated training for you and your colleagues. Check out academy.vector.com for our course program. See ya!